In this experiment, we will build a simple electrical circuit that will demonstrate the functioning of a rheostat. For this, we need a 9-volt battery connected to a battery snap and crocodile clips. You can also alternatively use a 1.5 volt battery. We will also need a safety pin, a torch bulb mounted on a torch bulb holder with insulated wires attached to the holder's terminals, and a graphite pencil lead. To mount the circuit, we will need a thermocol board and a cellophane tape to tape the pencil lead to the board. To set up the circuit, connect one crocodile clip to one of the insulated lead wires from the torch bulb holder and connect the other crocodile clip to a safety pin. Wrap the other insulated lead wire from the torch bulb holder around one end of the graphite pencil lead. Tape the graphite pencil lead to the thermocol board so that it does not move. Touching the safety pin to the graphite pencil lead will close the circuit and cause the torch bulb to glow. Now, move the safety pin up and down the length of the graphite pencil lead and observe if there is any change in the brightness of the torch bulb. You will notice it glows brightest when the safety pin is on one end of the graphite pencil lead and glows dimly when it is on the other end. Why does this happen? A rheostat is an electrical instrument that is used to control the electric current flowing through a circuit. The rheostat allows us to vary the resistance in the circuit, which in turn increases or decreases the current available to appliances or other components connected in the circuit. In everyday life, rheostats are used to control the speed of a fan or control the brightness of lights. In this experiment, the piece of graphite pencil lead acts like a simplified rheostat. In the electrical circuit here, the current flows from the positive terminal of the 9-volt battery through the lead wires of the battery snap, the lead wires of the torch bulb holder, the graphite pencil lead, the safety pin, and the other lead wire of the battery snap. The resistance of these individual components add up to form the total resistance of the circuit. As the safety pin slides up and down the pencil lead, the length of the pencil lead that becomes part of the circuit varies. As the pin slides away from the end of the lead where the wire from the torch bulb holder is connected, a larger piece of the pencil lead becomes part of the circuit. As a result, the total resistance in the circuit increases and the current passing through the torch bulb decreases. This makes the bulb's glow become dimmer. As the safety pin slides towards the end of the graphite lead where the wire from the torch bulb is connected, the circuit's total resistance decreases and the current flowing through the circuit increases, making the torch bulb glow more brightly than before.